the World of Company Secretaries, Season 2. Today, we have with us an All India ranker at both the levels, at executive and at professional level, who is CS Vikram Singh. Welcome to our show, CS Vikram Singh.
Thank you. Thank you so much for having me.
Tell us all about yourself and how did you choose CS and why did you choose company secretary as a profession amidst all other professions?
Okay, so when I was pursuing my Bachelor of Commerce Honours from Delhi University, I had to pursue a professional course as well. So I was figuring out what courses to pursue ahead, and I stumbled upon CA and CS. So I've always been someone who was really into theoretical subjects, and I would wanted to pursue something in the field of law, but not civil and criminal law. So when I stumbled upon an opportunity where I got to know that there is a course which teaches you about corporate law, so that seemed very interesting to me. So I was like, this is something into which I want to pursue my career in, and that's how my entire journey began.
Oh, that's wonderful. Why did you not think about, do you now as a professional feel that you should have also opted for CA or gone into law? Because as students, we all have that thing. Did we take the right choice by taking up company secretary? What do you feel about this?
No, not at all. I feel like that was the best moment when I decided that I want to pursue my career in CS, because it's not about what we pursue into, it's about how the best we can get out of it. So I think when I pursued CS, I could extract it the most out of the company secretary journey that has been my. So I feel like it's not what you do, it's how you do it. So I feel like when I started pursuing CS, I was able to, you know, give my best into this course and extracted the most out of it. So I still feel it's the best thing which I did.
Correct. So it should match your potential. It should match what you like, right? It's not just about what is out there. It's about what is inside you.
Exactly. Right?
Yes.
Exactly.
So we know you're an All India ranker. Tell us all about this. Our students would love to know about how you got there and how exciting was your journey so far.
Okay. So to be honest, I didn't prepare for All India rank. I was just, when I entered the profession, I entered with this one mindset that I want to clear all the attempts in first, all the stages in first attempt. And I gave myself a 3-year timeline that if I'm starting my CS journey in this year, I would want it to complete by the end of 3 years. So with this mindset, I entered the profession, and I just had this mindset only, and I was able to, you know, clear all the stages in first attempt. How I able to get the rank was another story, because I didn't prepare for it. I just prepared in order to clear all the stages in a single attempt. And I think that once you have this mindset that you have to, you know, clear all the stages in a single attempt and give all the groups together, so that gives you an upper hand in getting a rank also.
Correct.
So
how was your routine like? How was your discipline like? Of course, getting an All India rank is not a joke. You must have been truly disciplined, you know, hardworking and, you know, stuck to your ground, which is right. Quite hard, right? It's not easy. It doesn't come easy. So it's more like, you know, focus on the work that you're doing more and less on the results. That's right. Something that we can learn from you.
Right. So my teacher used to say this one thing that if you can, you have two options, okay? Either you can sacrifice your 6 months or you can sacrifice another 6 months.
Absolutely.
So I was like, okay, if I want to, you know, clear the stages, might as well do it in a single attempt and not waste another 6 months. So
right.
I had this mindset and I went full on into it. I used to, you know, I used to cut off from social media, from events, from vacations, everything. So I was like, if I am able to clear in this 6 months, I have the other 6 months to enjoy my life, which makes more sense. So with this thought, I used to study for 10 hours, 15 hours, whatever it used to take, with this just one thought that this is the only time I'm going to study. And if I'm able to clear it, the rest of the month, I'm going to enjoy. And that's what I did. So I feel like
what generally happens. Correct. So what generally happens with students is they generally take time, let's do it, and then they end up missing attempts, and what you can do in 6 months you end up doing in 2 years, and then they blame the whole CS course, and this is very difficult, I'm not able to clear it, this is not for me, and then that's where they lose their motivation and self-confidence, right? But yeah, I would want all students to take an inspiration from Vikram, that you see, he's a living example in front of you. 6 months, enjoy, right? You enjoy, you do whatever you want to do. But whenever you're supposed to do,
right.
Call it, yeah. So, how was your internship and work life being, and where are you currently working?
Okay, so after completing my professional stage, I started my articleship in a company called Eicher Motors in Gurgaon. So I completed my 21 months articleship in Eicher Motors. And then I was someone who really wanted to move abroad since my childhood. And when I entered CS, I got to know that ICSI has a MOU signed with ICSI, which is a institute of UK Chartered Secretary. So I used to research a lot about that institute and what opportunities I can get abroad. So I was searching about these opportunities, and then I got to know that, okay, there are many company secretaries who are settled in Dubai as well. So right. I was like, okay, this might seem an interesting place to move into, because UK, for you to move to UK, you'll have to have a chartered secretary degree of UK, for which you need to have 2 years post-membership qualification. So my plan was to, move abroad, get some experience, and then ultimately move to UK. Because UK is in West, it's comparatively difficult to move to the West, considering the visa and everything. So I made a plan to move to UK, move to Dubai after completing my articleship.
Wow, that's great. How exciting it is for students to think about getting a job in Dubai or Middle East just right after your company secretary course. So tell us about how students can approach moving abroad. See, everybody wants to move abroad, wants to have a good life, explore opportunities, but it doesn't come easy, right? So
right.
Would you have a roadmap for students to, look outside of India and look for opportunities? Do you have like a step plan or something that they should do along with their studies or even as qualified company secretaries?
Right. So I'll give you a roadmap as to how I ended up moving here and what other students can also do. And it's an interesting fact that when I was thinking to move to Dubai, I came across a video on your channel only, The World of Company Secretaries, where Mr. Alok did an interview with someone who was working in Dubai as well. So I saw that one video on your channel only, and I was like, okay, if this guy can move to Dubai,
the first episode of
why can I not? So that was the thing which motivated me in the first place to move to Dubai. So what I did was, ICSI hosts conference, international conference every year in Dubai or in any other countries. So for example, this year they're hosting a conference in Singapore. Okay. So what I did when I was in my articleship, I got to know that ICSI is hosting a conference in Dubai, and I just went to that conference. Okay. When I went to that conference, I met a lot of company secretaries who are settled in Dubai for the last 1 or 2 decades. Okay. And I got to know what's the scope of company secretary, what's the scope of compliance in Middle East, not just Dubai. And I got a positive feedback from them. Okay, so when I went back to India, I started applying. It took me a few months because sitting in India and getting an opportunity in Dubai, it's comparatively difficult.
So stressful.
Yeah. It is. Because here in Dubai, or as far as Middle East concerned, they consider GCC experience, which is Gulf Country Council. So even if you have an Indian experience, they might not consider you. And even if you have 4 or 5 years experience, you still have to fresh a start in Dubai. So if you are still a fresher, if you haven't got on the job experience, you are just, you have just completed your articleship, there's a roadmap how you can move to Dubai. First step is to come to any conference which is taking place international, be it Singapore, be it Dubai, this helps you to connect with people.
Be present, like travel there and meet people physically so that, you know, so that's the first step.
Exactly. Because once you travel abroad, once you see the people, once you interact with someone who's from your field, who's staying abroad and who's working there, you'll get a better idea of how to move there and what opportunities you can get. And they might be in a position to give you reference as well. Because here in Middle East, reference works a lot. Okay. So you have to take a punt, you know, to go abroad to interact with the individuals of your field. So this is the first step according to me. That's what I did. Okay. Secondly, if you are in India, you can create your profiles on job portals which are prevalent in UAE. So there are many job portals which are prevalent in UAE. You can just create your profiles and start applying.
Examples.
And start applying. Example like Indeed, Gulf Talent, Monster Gulf, Naukrigulf.com. So there are many platforms on which you can, LinkedIn as well. LinkedIn, I feel like LinkedIn is the best source for a networking and for jobs as well. So you have these many portals. You can just create your profiles on these platforms and you can just start applying. So this is the second way to, you know, to get a job abroad. And the third way is to just come to Dubai or just come to wherever you want to and just start applying by physically present here. Because the companies will always consider someone who's physically present over someone who's sitting in India. I got placed from sitting in India. But that is, I feel like you have to wait many months in order to grab that opportunity. I waited for 4-5 months from India in order to have an opportunity in Dubai. So if you are in a hurry, you want to get placed within a timeline of 1-3 months, you can just come to Dubai and, you know, start applying physically here. So I feel like these are the three ways, these are three steps how someone can easily move to Dubai.
That's practical.
And get an opportunity as well. Yeah.
Yes. But again, it needs a lot of caliber and patience for somebody to sit in India and keep hoping for something there, right? But the insights that you gave today to actually be physically present, let it be a conference or you go to Dubai and you stay there, meet people, network, build your LinkedIn profile, build your skill sets. Again, we will talk about building skill sets again. So this is your three-step formula to having reaching to a great opportunity at Dubai.
Absolutely. That's what I did. And it worked for me in big ways. When I first came to Dubai, I just attended the conference. It didn't help me to get an opportunity, but it helped me open my mind as to what I need to do in order to get an opportunity. So I feel like whatever it takes to, you know, to get you where you're supposed to get you where you want to reach, whatever it takes, you should do that.
Correct.
So I think these three steps helped me to move where I wanted to be. And I feel like someone who's really hungry, who, you know, want to get out, if they just focus on these three steps, in a matter of 6 months, they move here. And I know that students take it as a risk, take it as a punt to, you know, to come to a different place, spend some time. It involves a lot of cost and it involves a lot of time. So I know it is a risk, but I'm telling you, to all the students, that it is worth the risk.
That's great. I think that's what students want to hear from you, because there's always a dilemma, a question in their minds. Is it even worth the whole risk? You're spending time, you're spending money, and, you know, especially at a stage where you're still student, you're still dependent on the family, and then you're spending a lot of money. You don't know whether it's going to turn out or not for you. You don't know whether you're going to crack that opportunity 100% sure. You don't have that, right? So I'm sure you must have built or honed your skill sets before you went there, because again, if you do not have right amount of skills to get into a job, of course, the interview is not going to entertain you, right? So in the meanwhile, where about that 4-5 months where you sat and, you know, waited, what were the skill sets that you tried to build and what was it that you really did?
Okay, so first, which I consider is the most important skill set out of everything, is the communication skills and how you portray yourself. How is your personality? Because once you step into international market, people focus more on the personality, more on how you communicate rather than your technical aspect. Okay, technical aspect is there, But still, whatever you you know, whatever you present on the first meeting, that is where the impression goes, right? So I feel and I believe also that communication skills is the most important skill set, be it any profile, just not just company secretary, be it anywhere you go, be it a CA or a CS or a CMA. I feel communication is the most important and most essential skill set which everyone needs to work on. So so that's that. And second is obviously you need to have certain technical aspects as to international markets. Now, a lot of students ask me that what they need to prepare in order to get an opportunity in Dubai. It's not very technical, but I'll just give you a simple, you know, step by step as to what you need to be aware about. So when you come about, when you come to an international market, you interview don't expect you to be a master in international markets, because they obviously know that you have experience in Indian market. So they know that, okay, you just need to be aware as to what works in international markets. So students can, you know, start reading or learning about international laws, corporate international laws. So for example, in India, we have Companies Act, right? In international markets, for example, in UAE, they have their own Companies Act. So you can just, you know, download that Companies Act from the website of the government, which is there in UAE, UAE government website. You can just download that Companies Act, and then you can start, you know, reading through it. The intent is the same, but some aspects of law is different. So I feel like once you have studied Indian law, you have understand how to interpret the law, it becomes very easy to understand different markets laws as well, be it UAE, be it UK. So that is the second technical aspect you can work on. So I feel these are the two things which everyone needs to work on. And yeah, interviews expect you to be aware of international market as to what kind of compliances are there. Okay. So they don't go into the deep technical aspect, but they just will ask you.
On a broad basis.
Exactly. Exactly.
Yes.
Exactly.
So you have removed the fear out of students that they need to have strong technical skill sets before any interview. So all they need to know is just about what is there and not really into the nuances of it, right? So they just need to be aware, and it's important for them to build their skill set and not waste time before the interview, right? So these are a few takeaways from Vikram that students can take.
Right. And even if you're applying for a company, so you can just have an in-depth search about as to what the company does, where the company has offices in, what kind of compliances does this company can, you know, can be entered into. So I think the markets here, they just want you to be aware as to what can be done. And they don't ask you what is the nuances of a particular thing. You just have to have as a all-rounder idea as to what this market has to offer. So you can get a lot of information over the YouTube, over Google, and in the Companies Act as well. That is enough in order to equip you with all the information you need to crack the interview.
There's so much resources out there now that just with a click of a button, you're able to access everything. So the point is to actually access it, learn whatever specifically you need to know, you need to know. You cannot just go into an interview and explore an opportunity without being prepared. Only when you're well prepared, only then when an opportunity knocks at your door, you're able to welcome it with open arms, right? Yes.
Exactly. Yeah.
Type of student would want to know how different is it, how happy is it, or how exciting, how is it going for you?
For me, it's a different world altogether, because I was someone who always wanted to move outside. And first, I came to Dubai as a traveler, as a visitor. And when I entered here, I felt like this is the place where I wanted to be. And CS is the medium which allowed me to fulfill my dream. Okay. So, and when I entered, there are so many opportunities, not just in job, in other aspects as well, that once you come here, you'll be able to extract the full potential of yourself, not just in job, but in other areas as well. And for me, it happened the same. I had multiple opportunities in India, I was working in a similar, in a limited scope of work profile. When I moved here, I got introduced to so many different aspects as to governance, as to risk, as to compliance. These are the profiles which we do not get to here in India. There are separate departments which take care of these. But once you come to international markets, you can pursue governance and compliance. You can pursue anti-money laundering. You can pursue sanctions compliances. So these opportunity will, you know, will make you understand what goes on in the international market. And once you are able to learn about that, you can actually go anywhere in the world. So I feel like Dubai is like a trampoline. You just need to, you know, jump on the trampoline and the world is your place.
Great, well said. So the scope of work that you are exposed to in international markets and the kind of opportunities you see there is way higher and way big, right? Coming to the last thing, how do you see yourself? What kind of a future do you see as a CS professional? And what would you suggest? How do you see, you know, just like a advice to all the CS students who are still, you know, studying and trying to get to the other side, trying to get to the greener side, tell them how, as a CS professional, you see this whole future?
Okay, so first of all, I would want to reach out to the students that don't limit yourselves, don't limit your dreams, don't limit your potential. Because when I started, I didn't know that I would be here. I just have a hope that I will be able to make it till this point. And I feel that if a student has that potential, if a student has that belief that whatever the situation may be, if you are not able to clear exams, if you are not able to, you know, get a good training, that doesn't mean that you will be in the same position for the rest of your life. So always aim for the biggest thing you can in your life and work towards it. It will eventually happen. Sooner or later, it will happen. And I would see company secretary in the coming years, once you have a thing, once you have a niche for international markets, you are able to dive into other areas of work as well, which might not be, which you might not have seen in India. So I feel there's a whole sea of work profile which is waiting for company secretaries to dive into. We just need to dive into that. So there are a lot of things that we are unaware about as of now because we haven't tapped that market yet. But once you come here, once you come to any other market as well, you'll be able to expose to so many different things that we haven't even heard about. So there are so many things which company secretaries can dive into, and not just, you know, secretarial, in any other part, be it merchant banking, be it investment banking, whatever anyone wants to do. We are all capable of doing anything which they are able to think of. So I feel this is my message to all the students, is to not to limit your potential, just to have that belief that whatever you want to achieve in life is possible, be it wherever you are right now.
It's all about taking one thing at a time, one step at a time, one baby step at a time to get you. You just didn't reach at a place. Every time, even since your education journey, you just said your aim was not to get an All India ranker, right? Your aim was to just do the right thing every day for the next six months, just do the right thing. And then after you qualified, you had the patience to actually wait. You knew what you wanted, which most students still don't. Even after they qualify, they don't exactly know what they want because it's a world of opportunities. When you're a student, you're just sitting behind the books and, you know, your limited knowledge, you're not exposed to the opportunities and the world out there. And once you just come out, you're a fresher, you're a newborn baby in the world. There is so many opportunities. You don't know what exactly to take, what to filter out. So everybody needs to take in that time, filter the opportunities, understand what they want to get in. And to get there, have that patience, right? It's not just going to happen in a month or like 2 months. You waited for, let's say 4 months or 6 months, 4 to 6 months to actually land up at your job. So we actually appreciate your patience there and your, you know, the way you held on to that. This is what I want and this is what I'm going to work for. And your life there, the opportunities that you have explain to us seems quite exciting, and I'm sure students are going to draw inspiration and they're going to work hard in their studies, and then once they qualify, they're going to have a fixed goal and work like you. It was a pleasure speaking to you, Vikram.
Thank you. Thank you so much. The pleasure is all mine. Thank you so much.
Thank you. Thank you for coming to our show.
Thank you so much.
Thank you, Vikram.